I welcome you all for this today's lecture. I, Professor Mahavir Chokla. Students, in the previous classes, we discussed a few examples on endpoint DFT. And in the today's lecture, I have come up with the new concept, topic, known as DFT as a linear transformation. That is the matrix relation or method for computing DFT. So in this particular topic, we'll understand how matrix relation can be used for the computation of endpoint DFT. So let us begin with the basic definition of endpoint DFT. As you all know, the definition of the DFT, the mathematical definition for DFT, which is given by x of k is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n w n k. So let me consider this one as equation number 1. So this is the mathematical definition for endpoint DFT. So now let us evaluate this DFT for different values of k ranging from 0 to n minus 1. And here k varies from what? 0 to 0, 1 up to n minus 1. So let us evaluate this DFT equation for different values of k ranging from 0 to n minus 1. So let us begin with k is equal to 0. So if I substitute k is equal to 0 here, I will get x of 0. And here summation values, the n values varies from 0 to n minus 1. So n is 0 first and k is also 0. So we'll get x of 0 because n is equal to 0 initially. And here k is 0 and n is also 0. So we'll get wn 0 plus n is equal to 1. So x of 1 wn. N is equal to 1 but k is equal to 0, so 0 1 2 0 into 1 is again 0 plus next n is equal to 2, that is you will get x of 2 into wn. N is 2 but k is 0, so 0 into 2 is again 0, you will get x of 2 into wn 0, so on up to plus what is the last value of this n, that is n minus 1. So here I will write x of n minus 1 wn. The n value is capital N minus 1 but k value is initially we are evaluating for k is equal to 0, so 0 into n minus 1 is also what? 0. So this is the equation we got by evaluating this DFT x of k for k is equal to 0. And now let us evaluate for one more value of k, that is k is equal to 1. So let us write the equation for x of 1. So again n starts from 0. So it is x of 0 wn. K is equal to 1 and n is equal to 0. So 1 into 0 is 0 plus next n is equal to 1 wn. Here n is equal to 1 and k is also 1, so 1 into 1 is 1 plus if you substitute n is equal to 2, what you will get? X of 2 wn, k is 1, n is 2, so 1 into 2 is wn raised to 2 you will get, so on up to plus x of the last value of n is n minus 1 into wn, k is value is 1 and the last value of n is n minus 1, so what you will get here is n minus 1. Similarly, I'll substitute x of 2, that is k, k is equal to 2. What equation will get? X of 0, Wn 0 plus x of 1, and here you will get n is equal to 1 and k is equal to 2, so 1 into 2 is 2, you will get here, then so on up to the last value is what? X of n minus 1, and here you will get n value is n minus 1 and k value is what here? K is equal to 2 and n value is n minus 1, so you will get 2 times n minus 1. So similarly, for n varies from 0 to n minus 1, k also varies from 0 to n minus 1. So let us evaluate for last value of k, that is x of n minus 1, which is equal to x of 0 wn 0, because the first value of n is 0 here, 0 into n minus 1 is 0, plus x of 1 wn, here n value is 1 and k value is n minus 1, so 1 into n minus 1 is, you will get n minus 1, plus so on up to last value of n is n minus 1, n minus 1 wn. What is the k value? K is evaluating for n minus 1, so here k value is n minus 1, and the last value of small n is also what? N minus 1. So these are the n number of DFT equations you will get from 0 to n minus 1, means there will be n DFT equations with how many unknowns? You will get n unknowns, right? So with n different DFT equations having n number of unknowns, these equations can be written, can be put in the matrix form as this. I can write capital X, this is nothing but capital X, and here you can write, and here you can write, if I collect all these W terms, I can write here Wn, and this X of 0 to X of n minus 1, these are the sample values of what? Elements of the input sequence X of n, right? So that I will write small x. So capital X is the DFT vector and small x is the input vector, right? You can say the matrix, this is output DFT matrix, this is input DFT matrix, and this Wn is called as what? The DFT matrix, right? And both this X as well as small x, they have the matrix size n cross, right? N cross 1 means it is a column matrix. Both x and small x, they are the column matrix. So this is x of 0, x of 1 up to x of n minus 1. So how many rows are there? N number of rows are there. How many columns are there? There is only one column. Similarly, this small x is also a column matrix called as input matrix, whose samples are given by x of 0, x of 1, so on up to x of n minus 1. Again, if you see how many number of rows are there, n rows are there, one column is there, right? So both capital X and small x, they are the column matrices having size n cross 1, and this Wn is n cross n matrix, square matrix. Wn is square matrix of size n cross n, right? So let us write, using these equations, let us write the matrix relation so how to write so first I will write the output DFT sequence, that is in matrix form, that is x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, so on up to what? X of n minus 1. So this is my capital X is equal to, here I will write the DFT matrix. And this DFT matrix has the elements which are a complex values, complex basis functions. So how to write? The first element is what? W n raised to zeros, right? See the first equation, that is for x of 0, for k is equal to 0, see the W values. So W n raised to 0, so on up to what? W n raised to 0, the last element of W n from the first equation. Similarly, from the second equation, what is the first element of W n? Again it is 0. The second element is what? W n raised to 1. And what is the last element? It is W n, n minus 1. Similarly, the next one is W n raised to 0, W n raised to 2, so on up to what? W n raised to, it is 2 times n minus 1. And similarly, for last, it is W n 0, and here it is W n, n minus 1. You can see the last equation, right? I'm just collecting all W terms from those equations, that's all. And here n minus 1, n minus 1. And similarly, this DFT matrix is going to multiply with the elements of the input sequence or sample values of input sequence. So they are namely x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, and the last sample is what? X of n minus 1. So this is the matrix relation for computing n-point DFT. So this is called as the output DFT sequence, right? Or this is the input matrix, that is input sequence, and this is known as a DFT matrix. And these are the elements of what? The DFT matrix. They are mainly what? The complex values, right? So now I can write, if you know the output sequence x is equal to W n into small x, and this W n is the DFT matrix whose elements are given by what? W n k n. By substituting k values and n values, you will get different values for elements for this W n, that is DFT matrix. So now let us understand what is the matrix relation for computing IDFT. This is for what? The matrix relation for computing DFT. So now let us study the matrix relation for computing n point IDFT, right? So if you know the matrix relations for computing n point DFT, then you can derive the relation for computing IDFT also, right? We know that the matrix relation for n point DFT is what? Capital X is equal to W n, which is DFT matrix, multiplied by what? The input sequence X. Both this X as well as small x, they are column matrix having size n cross 1, and this W n is DFT matrix, which is a squared matrix of size n cross n, right? So from this, let us multiply this equation both the sides by W n raised to minus 1, W n raised to minus 1. So what I am doing is, here I am multiplying both sides of this equation by W n raised to minus 1. So the LHS becomes what? W n raised to minus 1 capital X, which is equal to RHS W n raised to minus 1, and here it is W n, and here it is x, right? And this W n raised to plus 1 and W n raised to minus 1, they are get cancels. So we have W n raised to minus 1 capital X is equal to what? A small x, right? And this small x can be obtained, that is the IDFT sequence small x can be obtained by multiplying the output DFT sequence with the DFT matrix, the inverse DFT matrix, right? this w n raised to minus 1, this w n raised to minus 1 is known as IDFT matrix. Please remember, w n is known as DFT matrix, w n raised to minus 1 is known as IDFT matrix. IDFT matrix. So I can write small x is equal to w n raised to minus 1 capital X, and this w n raised to minus 1 is known as IDFT matrix, right? And one more point is here, you know the definition of IDFT, the basic definition, mathematical definition for IDFT, right? And the definition goes like this: x of n is equal to 1 divided by n summation, here it is k is equal to 0 to n minus 1, DFT sequence x of k multiplied by, here it is minus kn, where n is 0, 1 up to capital N minus 1, right? So x of n is equal to 1 by n summation, k is equal to 0 to n minus 1, x of k, and this w n minus raised to k n is there. So this I will write as w n k n, and its star means it is conjugate, right? So please remember, w n raised to minus k n can be written as w n k n raised to star. So this is nothing but a conjugate. Conjugate means changing the sign of the imaginary part, right? So then, so it is 1 divided by n, 1 divided by n, look at this one. This can be again written in the matrix form. This is capital X, right? And what is this? If this W n raised to k n can be written as what? DFT matrix W n, and here it is conjugate. So therefore, this is this small x, x of n I will write in the matrix form small x, which is 1 divided by n w n raised to star, which is conjugate, into capital X, right? So what we understand from this, what we can derive from this equation is, just by knowing DFT matrix W, taking its conjugate, if it is also possible to compute the IDFT of the sequence x of k, right? So no need to compute IDFT matrix, just take the DFT matrix and take its conjugate. Conjugate means wherever there is imaginary, just change the sign of that imaginary value, you will get IDFT matrix. Then multiply with DFT sequence and divide it by capital N, so you will get the IDFT sequence X, right? So this W n raised to minus 1, W n raised to minus 1 is the conjugate of, is the conjugate of, conjugate of W n, W n multiplied by 1 by n. Therefore this W n raised to, see, you just compare this one, this one with this one with this equation, right? So both are identical, except in place of, in place of w n raised to minus 1, what you will get? 1 divided by n w, right? So remember this one, multiplied by what? 1 divided by w. This star, w star conjugate. So this is about the matrix relation for computing DFT as well as IDFT. So here you have to remember the two important equations. One is capital X is equal to w n into small x. This is for DFT, and for IDFT the matrix relation is what? Small x, 1 divided by n, and here it is w n star into capital X. This is for idea of it.